Good day. Today I'm going to update the firmware on my internal multi-module of my Jumper T16 transmitter. Wait, didn't I already do that before? Yes, as a matter of fact, I did. That was back when I didn't have the bootloader installed on my internal module because I had one of the earlier versions of the Jumper T16 Pro. At that time, I had to use an external USB to serial adapter and a custom wiring harness. It wasn't all that bad. However, since there are many updates to the internal module firmware for various reasons, it could become annoying if I had to do it that way all the time. In fact, since that initial firmware update video I did just 3 months ago, there have already been 4 more updates to the multi-module firmware, and at the time of this video's posting, there's another update in the works to accommodate FreeSky's latest release of their ACCST firmware, which is dated January 16th, 2020, so be on the lookout for that update. Fortunately for all of us, the multi-module devs, in concert with OpenTX, have made it a lot easier for us to do the updates. No need for an external adapter or a special wiring harness. We can do the updates in 3 simple steps and just a few short minutes just by using our computer and transmitter. Sound good to you? Then give it a thumbs up below and subscribe to your TMac FPV channel, your home for your journey to better FPV fun, flights, and racing. Stop! All right, the first thing we're going to do to update our multi-module firmware is go to this site, multi-module.org, which has been updated by Mr. Ben Lai. This is also where you can donate to the developers of the multi-module firmware by going to this tab and clicking on Donate, and then you can do so through PayPal. I'll make sure to put this link in the video description below. So we go to this website of Mr. Ben Lai, and from here we go to Update Methods. And this site takes you step by step through everything you need. For update methods, he says there's 3 ways to do that: through a compatible radio running OpenTX, using Flash Multi, or compiling the firmware yourself. We're not going to demonstrate all 3 of these. I'm just going to use my compatible OpenTX radio, which is the Jumper T16 in this case. Now, in order to update your multi-module firmware using a compatible radio running OpenTX, it requires the multi-module to have the multi-module bootloader installed. And as Mr. Lai says, most of the modules already have this, with the exception of internal modules in the early T16 Pro radios. You should be able to update the multi-module firmware with the radio if the firmware version on the module is version 1.2.1.85 or newer. To check out the version of your multi-module firmware, what you need to do is go to your model setup menu and scroll to where you normally bind your receiver using the multi-module. And right here is where you can see the module status, the version that's on your multi-module. So in this case, I've got version 13047 AETR installed as the firmware for my multi-module. Now, if you don't have a version 1.2.1.85 or newer, then you'll need to install the bootloader onto your multi-module. And I've got a video on that, which you can check out here, that shows you how to go step-by-step through that in a very simple process. Since I've got version 1.2.1.85 or newer already installed, that's the reason I can update my module firmware using my compatible radio running OpenTX. So flashing from the radio, you follow these steps. Basically, we're going to download the firmware to our computer, we're going to copy that firmware onto our radio, and then we're going to flash the module using the file on the radio. So the first thing we need to do is download the module firmware onto our computer. To do that, we're going to go over to Firmware Files and Pascal Langer's site. We see that the latest release is 13053 at the time we're posting this particular video. So we can click on that, or actually, just scroll down. One thing you want to do is take a look at your channel orders, because the 3 channel orders, AETR, RETA, and TAER, are denoted in the firmware file names. Each build expects to receive the channel data from the radio in the order given in the name. You must match the channel order of your models to the order which your multi-module expects. For example, if you're using models as TAER, flash your multi-module with firmware TAER in the name. I've got my model set up in AETR, so that's what I'm going to look for. I'm going to look for the firmware file 13053 AETR and no INV for the internal module. So I'm going to scroll down here to 13053 AETR, no INV for the internal module. I'm going to click on that. It's going to download over here. I'm going to copy and paste it into my Jumper T16 multi-module folder. Right click, paste. And now I've got this 13053 AETR for my channel order, which matches my channel order of my models. No INV for internal module. I've got that on my computer. All we need to do now is copy and paste that to our Jumper T16 SD card. Now to get this file onto our SD card of our Jumper T16 or your compatible radio running OpenTX, there's two ways we can do that. One way is by using a USB to micro SD adapter, which is what I used last time. Just stick the micro SD card into the side here on this particular adapter and then plug it into your computer. You do that after you remove the SD card, obviously, from the back of the Jumper T16 or wherever it is on your particular compatible radio. Since I used that method last time, I'm going to use a different method this time, and we're going to put the or power up the radio in bootloader mode by pushing these two tabs together, T1 and T4, and pressing the power button. And then plug the transmitter into the computer using this cable. And now it says USB is connected. And over here, we see that our SD card shows up as Jumper T16D. It might be a different drive for you, but in my case, it's the D drive. Now you can put this file anywhere on the SD card just so that you know where it's at. I'm going to place it under firmware, which is where I placed my 13047 version. So to do that, I've got two windows open here. This one on the left is my SD card folder. This one on my right is the computer folder where I saved the firmware file to from the download site. So I'm just going to go right click and copy, and then click over here on the left hand screen and right click and paste it there, remembering that I got it under Jumper T16 firmware, and now my 13053 version is there. Having done that, I can now disconnect the radio. Click exit. The radio automatically turns on once I do that. We're going to press and hold the sys button, radio setup, and we're going to page. And we're going to go to firmware, click enter. And here we've got the file which we just uploaded onto our SD card, the multi-module firmware, OpenTX AETR in my case, since that's the channel order I downloaded to match the model channel order that I've got. No INV because I'm doing the internal module. And it's 13053. The number one, don't worry about, that's just because I downloaded it twice onto my computer. I'm gonna click on that. And it gives you options, flash internal multi, flash external multi, or these other ones. Since I've got an internal module, I'm going to use flash internal multi. I'm gonna flash internal multi. We're gonna click that and watch the status bar down here at the bottom. Flash successful, and that's a good thing. All right, now we hit return. And now to check that our firmware file has been uploaded and written to our internal multi-module, we go back into the model setup page by pressing and holding here, and we scroll down or up. I'm gonna scroll up to get to that area where we normally bind the receiver. Just above that will show our firmware version. And here you see, under module status, model setup menu, we've got version 13053 AETR now installed on our internal multi-module. We're good to go! Now you know how to update your multi-module firmware with just your computer and transmitter. I hope you found this useful, and if so, share it with your friends. Thanks for your time, and I'll see you next video. Clear skies, friend!